You should have your paid for subscription set up now. And what we're going to look at now is how we can add a virtual machine to your paid for subscription. So on the left hand side, click on virtual machines and then select add. As you can see, there are a plethora of virtual machines you can select from. Linux machines or some that are specific to certain workloads, such as SQL databases or SharePoint servers. We're going to select Windows Server, and we're then going to select Windows Server 2016 Data Center. You have the option of the deployment method being either Resource Manager or Classic. The recommended deployment method is Resource Manager, which uses the latest services within Microsoft Azure. So click on Create. And one of the things we need to do is fill in the details, such as give the virtual machine a name. We also need to have a username, which will be the administrator of that server. And we also need to put in a password and obviously then confirm that password. We also need to create a new resource group for all the services that will be used by the Windows virtual machine. So give that a name. We also need a location where it will be stored. We now need to select the size of the virtual machine. You can see here that there are some that have been recommended to you, and some of these have different CPUs and different memory. If we select the view all, then we can see all of the different types of virtual machine that we can install. As they get more powerful, then they, on a monthly basis, will increase as well. So we're going to select one, click select, and we just need to fill in a few little options. We can have a high availability section if we want. We also need to fill in details for network, subnet, etc. For now, we're going to leave these as they are. So once we've looked at the other options, if we click on OK, we can see a summary of what's going to be installed and the size of the virtual machine and the pricing and all the settings that we put into the configuration in the other screens. So if we click on Create, you can see now that it's gone back to the dashboard and you can see that the Windows server is being deployed. Once that's finished, then we'll look at how we can actually remotely connect to that Windows server. So, deployment's finished. If we click on the icon in the dashboard, you can see here that we've got options. We can view the CPU usage, the network traffic. What we want to do is actually connect to the virtual machine. So, at the top, we click on the connect, and what it will do is download an RDP file to be used with the remote desktop software on Microsoft. So, click on that, it'll open up. Enter the details that we put in for the administrator and the password, and then click on OK. And as you can see, it's remoting into that server. It's a standard Windows 2006 server. It'll take a short while to load up. So once we've remoted in, you can see that the standard Windows 2016 server starts to load up. As it's the first time that we've used the server, it will take a while to load up, but eventually you can see that the Windows background loads up and we now have a server that we can start to install software to. Now it may be that you use this server as a test server for testing out software or updates before they are deployed to your on-premise equipment and your production environment. You can obviously also use this virtual machine for more advanced features, such as extending your network from on-premise to the cloud and using this as another server within your network. What we're going to do now is shut the machine down, as one of the things you need to understand about Azure is that even though you have shut the Windows server down, it will keep using services and therefore costing you money. If you do not want to use the server again for a number of days, then the best option is to click on the stop button at the top. Once we click yes, then what this will do is deallocate the server, so it will stop using services and therefore stop costing you any money. This is the ideal solution if you are using it for as a test server. So if you're using it to test services or updates, then you may want to use it for a few days and then deallocate it so it's not costing you any money until the next time you need to use it.